How about neck pain?
Nope.
No?
I stretch every morning.
What about numbness or tingling sensations in your hands?
Probably the entire first meeting was me crying and telling him, I don't want to be in a wheelchair. I want to have more children. What am I supposed to do? When you first hear of arthritis, you think of somebody getting that in their elder years, not at 28.
Ellen is a great gal. When she initially came to me, she was extremely upset. She was told that she could not have children. She was told many things, and that there wasn't much that can be done. She really wanted to have her children.
And he said to me, you know, let me treat you, and I'll get you through your pregnancy. But after that, you know, you're mine. You know, I'm going to get you on the right treatment, and we're going to find a way to get you to do all the things that you love to do.
This is a girl who, truly a fighter, put up with a tremendous amount of pain and discomfort for quite some time. When she was ready, we brought her in and we began a treatment protocol. Her quality of life is clear. She, in her wisdom, decided that this was not going to get her down. And over time, she became a fitness instructor.
Just stay in a gym situation where I was just surrounded by so much energy and so much passion for feeling good and feeling fit kind of gave me a specialty, which was really, you know, it's a good place to be in that world. Keep your head nice and straight, so don't let it go. There you go, right there. Perfect. Does it bother your shoulders?
Nope.
Good. You know, at 35, I was going to be in a wheelchair, and now, you know, 7 years beyond that, I'm a fitness instructor, and I'm teaching babies how to swim.
Good job, sweet pea.
And if I wasn't able to move, if the rheumatoid arthritis had originally gone in the direction it was told to me that it would go, I wouldn't have any of this.
There's tremendous hope. The concept for the rheumatologist today is that we're trying to treat our patients so they're ready for the cure when it comes. If a patient is not treated quickly and appropriately, then they begin to have damage. We can't really reverse that damage. All right, let me just put you through range of motion. But what we can do is slow it to a point where when a cure does come, it'll be appropriate for that patient and they will not lose function over time.
If I had to give anybody a message, it would be to advocate for themselves, to find the doctor that will work with them, whatever age they are, at whatever time and stage they are in their lives, so that they can live with the disease.